Hi, my name's Ed. Welcome to Ed Explains English, Life in the UK. Look what I just found in the attic, Judy. It's the Star family tree, which dates back to the 19th century.
Where did you find that?
It was in the attic. I was looking for some old photographs when I stumbled across it.
Did you find the photos too?
Yes, they are here. Some are very old black and white ones.
Hey, who's that? He looks just like you.
Well, I do see a resemblance. He was my great-grandfather, the man I was named after, Edward Starr.
But every firstborn boy in your family has been named after his father. Our son too, even though I wanted him to be called Stephen.
Here is his wife, my great-grandmother, Ethel Starr. They had a large family, 7 children, one of whom was my father's father, of course.
Your grandfather?
Sadly, I never met any of his 6 siblings, though. He had 3 brothers and 3 sisters. He was the youngest of them all.
Your father had lots of aunts and uncles, didn't he?
Yes, and over 20 cousins, as far as I can remember. They had larger families back then.
Well, you can look at the family tree to see all the names.
Oh yes, look, there's my mother's sister Mary. She and her husband Raymond were also my godparents.
But they were your aunt and uncle.
I know that, but they never had their own children, so my mum thought it would be nice. Besides, Uncle Ray used to insist that I call him the godfather.
They might not have had their own children, but they had a lot of nieces and nephews by the looks of it.
Family reunions are very big events, as you know.
As well as weddings. Which reminds me, we have to get a present for your cousin Kevin. He's getting married next month.
About time too. He's been engaged to his fiancée Sharon for so long I can't remember.
Who's going to be the best man?
His stepbrother Nick, I think. He should have chosen me. I had some wonderful anecdotes to tell of the time when we were teenagers.
That's exactly why he didn't choose you, Ed. Anyway, I've heard Sharon's family are very wealthy.
Yes, he's done very well for himself. His rich in-laws will no doubt invite him to join the family business.
I doubt it. I've heard Sharon's mother is the boss, and she's quite difficult to work with.
It wouldn't surprise me. Most mother-in-laws are battle axes.
Ed.
Except for your darling mother, my dear.
I suggest you get back up in the attic. I don't want to see you before dinner time. We would like to thank you for watching this video. Visit Instagram where you can find complimentary vocabulary for this and our other videos. Please like, comment and share this video with your friends, as well as subscribing. Thanks for watching. Toodle-pip!